me again, guys. It's your old friend David from Card Speed. And today, guys, we're going to probably talk about the most controversial subject in all of dirt kart racing. This subject has divided father and son. It's divided race teams. It's turned friends into foes. This topic is cross percentage. So let me paint a picture for you guys. It's race day. You just went out in pro qualifying, the big money race of the day. It's the race that you came down there for, the race that you've been preparing all week for. You had your best tire on for the situation. You really felt like you were going to be fast, only to find out that you're still 2/10 off. So you walk back in the trailer, you're disgusted, kind of downtrodden. You look at your tires and your chemicals and you're thinking to yourself, that should have worked. Why didn't that work? So you're thinking, you're kind of scrambling on what to do. You know, the more you think, the more you're stewing on it, the more disgusted you're getting. And it's kind of floating right here, you know? And you finally hit that breaking point and you go, that's it. We're making a change. So you grab your 2 3/4-inch wrenches, you head out the trailer to the front of the go-kart. By that time, your race friends are coming over, your buddies at the racetrack, and they're crowding around you because they see you're going to the front of the go-kart with some wrenches. And they're probably trying to start talking to you, giving you their advice. I imagine it sounds something like this.
Dumb.
Stupid.
Crazy.
Do it with the tires.
Dangerous.
Oh, I tickle myself sometimes, I tell you. Okay, so what is cross percentage? Well, cross percentage is the total weight of the left rear and the total weight of the right front divided by the total weight of the go-kart. So in this case, we have 138 pounds and 110 pounds. Okay, add those two together and then you divide it by 375. So the cross weight for this go-kart will be 66.1%. All right, don't get sick on me yet, okay? Don't quit yet, because we're just getting started. So this is the debate. You have one group of people that say, if you add cross to the go-kart, it's gonna tighten up. Then you have another group of people go, well, if you add cross to the go-kart, it's going to free it up, not tighten it up. And I'm going to give you the answer, okay? Now, guys, don't hate on me too much. Don't burn me. But I'm going to be as truthful as I possibly can. You ready? You sitting down? Here it goes. It's both.
Can't do this anymore, man. My head's about to explode.
All right, let me explain my answer. So, and this is just dirt kart specific. This doesn't include asphalt racing or road course racing. This is just for dirt kart oval. So, cross works on a bell curve, okay? And back in the day, like early 90s or mid 90s, we ran what you would consider low cross. Anywhere between 48% to like 58% cross, okay? Back then, when you added cross, the go-kart would go from loose to tight, okay? The go-kart would physically tighten up, okay? Nowadays, we run high cross go-karts, which is anywhere between 62-63% on up to probably in some people are running close to 80% depending, okay? Well, if you start adding that much cross to the go-kart, it goes from being tight to now loosening and freeing back up, okay? But what if you went extreme both sides? Well, if you keep adding cross and adding cross and adding cross, eventually you're going to start pushing, okay? Or If you took all the cross out of it and went down to, let's say, something crazy like 30% cross, the go-kart again would start pushing.
That don't make no sense.
Allow me to explain, okay? So this video, my intent for this video was to kind of give you the meat and potatoes of cross percentage. You know, the nuts and bolts, so you will be able to apply it at the racetrack and use it, okay? So I'm not going to fully get into all the physics and dynamics behind cross percentage, because that video will probably be about 4 hours long. So I'm just going to give you the what you need to know to be able to use it, okay? So a couple things that we need to establish first and foremost is, one, the most heavily loaded tire on the go-kart in a turn is going to be your right rear, just because of its location, okay? And most people in the karting community would agree with this, because where the right rear is located, when the go-kart starts building lateral acceleration, that tire is going to be the most heavily loaded tire of the whole go-kart, okay? All right. Static weight. Static weight is weight that is not moving. Like when you're scaling your go-kart at the shop, weight that is sitting still, not moving, is static weight. Dynamic weight is weight that is moving. When the go-kart again goes into the turn and starts building lateral acceleration or lateral G's, and it starts moving, that weight turns from static to dynamic, okay? So when the go-kart, well, let's talk about low cross, like in the early 90s, right? So whenever they were running low cross, let's say they were running 50% cross weight, okay? Now, none of these numbers are going to be exact. I'm just using these numbers. I'm pulling them off the hip just for an example, okay? Let's say your left rear was at 50 pounds and your right rear was at 50 pounds statically, okay? And when that go-kart goes into the turn and that weight and the lateral G's start moving that weight, and the right rear goes to 75 pounds, let's say the left rear goes to 25 pounds, your go-kart needs both tires working to be able to hold the back end down, okay? So if one tire gets too heavily loaded, the back end of the go-kart starts sliding, okay? So it's the way I like to explain it is, if you had two workers carrying a couch, like a sleeper sofa, right? And you had one worker just said, here, you hold it, and threw the whole couch onto one worker, he's going to drop it. Same thing with your rear tires, okay? If one tire gets overwhelmed because it can't handle the load that's being put on it, it's going to start sliding, right? So on a low cross situation at 50% cross, that left rear goes down to 25, or even let's say 20 pounds, and the right rear goes to 80 pounds, right? All of a sudden, the right rear is getting overwhelmed and it can't hold the back of the go-kart. So what happens? The back of the go-kart starts sliding and the go-kart becomes loose. So when you start putting more cross into it, now, just kind of slide these out of the way here with a finger, and then bring my eraser. Let's say we go to 54% cross, and that looks like 60 pounds of preload, and the right rear is now down to 40 pounds, okay? But now when it goes into the turn, now when it moves weight, let's say the right rear goes up to, we'll say 60 pounds, and then the left rear goes down to 40 pounds, okay? Now there's more load on the left rear, helping the right rear hold the back end down. So therefore, what happens to the go-kart? The go-kart tightens up.
Do what?
So let's look at a high cross situation, okay? In a high cross go-kart, again, these numbers are just for example purposes. Let's say your static load on your tires, your preload, is 130 pounds on your left rear and only 40 pounds on your right rear, okay? Well, when that go-kart goes into the turn and it starts loading the tires, let's say you don't transfer enough to the right rear, and let's say the right rear gets up to 70 pounds, okay? So that's 30 pounds, so, and the left rear is down to 100 pounds. There's not enough load on the right rear to hold the go-kart, so the left rear becomes overwhelmed. The go-kart starts sliding, okay?
Time for natties.
Hold your horses, Devo, or in your case, donkeys, all right? We're not done yet, okay? So what's the one thing you need to have weight transfer, okay? You have to have grip. In order to have weight transfer, you have to have grip. The more grip that you have, the more dynamic weight transfer you have. The less grip you have, the less dynamic weight transfer you have, okay? So let's talk about that for a second. Let's say the track is getting a whole lot more bite than what you were thinking. You know, the track getting really fast. Well, then what you would do then is you would go up and cross. Why? Because now you're having more grip, so you're getting more transfer. So now the right rear is becoming more loaded and the go-kart's tightening down. So therefore you go up and cross and lower the right rear preload. Therefore it will free the go-kart up. On the flip side, let's say it rains real hard and the track loses a lot of grip, okay? Well, with less grip, you'll have less dynamic weight transfer, and therefore, you know, if you have less dynamic weight transfer, that means that you're not transferring enough weight to your right front or to the right rear, and the go-kart wants to sit too much on the left rear, okay? So therefore, you go down and cross and help the weight transfer and put more preload on your right rear.
And I'm sure you've got data to back that up.
I'm glad you asked, Randy. So that's exactly what I got. So what you're looking at here is two different runs. Okay, on the graph here, all the way to your left is the start and finish line. This little blue piece here is the front straightaway. This green is turns 1 and 2. The blue here is the back straightaway. The red here is turns 3 and 4. And this little blue sliver here is the second half of the front straightaway going back to the start and finish line. The graph that we're looking at is the speed trace, which is the mile an hour of the go-kart throughout the whole lap, okay? The red is before the cross change. The green is after the cross change. Now, mind you, the tires were the same. The chemical was the same. The tire pressure was the same. And even the gear was the same. The only thing we changed between the two runs was the go-kart's cross percentage. The cross percentage in the green fit the track conditions more than the cross percentage that's in the test run that's represented by the red trace, okay? And as you can see, by just making a cross change, the go-kart picked up almost three and a half tenths a second a lap. It's 2.3 mile an hour faster going into turns one here. It's, let's see, 1.7 mile an hour faster at the end of the back straightaway going into turn three. And it is almost 3 mile an hour faster on the exit of turn four. And again, all we did was change the cross.
You know what, David? I bet you're right.
Hey, thanks, Mike. Guys, I hope the next time you guys are at the racetrack and you feel like you need to make a cross change, you don't act like Mrs. Klump. I hope that after watching this video, you're a little bit more like Delmer.
Come on in, boys. The water is fine.
Till next time, guys, remember, racing's tough. Don't be leaving any speed in the trailer.